Watch your step. You never know where a beast might lurk.
Guardians, what's going on, y'all? Sly here, back at it with part 3 of my Leviathan Raid Guide. So, last time we checked out how to tackle the Bather's Challenge. This time we're taking a look at the part that everyone seems to be stuck on, the puppies. Now, this part is known as the Pleasure Gardens. It's very, very reminiscent of the Gorgon's Maze in Vault of Glass, only this time you're supposed to kill them. So, after you complete the challenge's entry once again, head on into the room and walk around the gardens. There are majors around here everywhere, but they're easy to kill, and they drop lots of heavy ammo. Everyone should be using swords here. If you don't have a sword, a shotgun or a fusion could work, but you will be lagging behind in terms of damage. So make sure that you have a high damage super like Striker with pulse grenades, Nova Bomb, something like that. Something that continually damages enemies. If you need more heavy, just jump into the crevices at the base of the statue and start over. You keep your heavy, and then you can get more to drop by killing the yellow bars. Not only that, you can farm your super this way as well, which is also very helpful. So the idea here is that you have to kill all the hounds in the garden, but you only get a few chances to do so. They also have an enormous amount of health, so you have to again get a damage buff before you can do any real damage to them. Like I said earlier, everyone will need a sword here. You don't absolutely need it, but if your team messes up and you don't have a full damage buff, you'll wish you brought one with you. So how this encounter works is like this. There are 6 yellow bar dogs down there. Within these gardens, there are these flowers that are scattered all around the place. There are 8 in total. However, only 6 of them will be active at any one time. Those are the only ones you need to worry about. Now, it's a good idea to have you and your team roam around before you start and get acquainted to where each one is. The way my team and I did this is that we labeled them. Starting from the statue, looking back towards the room where we entered, we had the front left, far left, and then center left. Center left is in the cave located between the group of trees. Then the right side is the same way. You have front right, far right, and then the one inside the cave was labeled center right. Now it's a good idea to know where all of these flowers are and where to run in order to get back to the safe zone. Once you take a look around, notice the 2 prisms at the very top. What you're going to do here is designate 2 people to use these. Once you pick them up, a door will open up from the top and the 4 remaining will drop down into it. This is the safe room. Everyone will need to come back here at the end of every round, but more on that later. So, once the prisms are picked up, 1 goes left and 1 goes right. Notice the beams of light on top of these rocks. You'll need to stand on them a little later. So, the 4 that drop down, you will see 4 purple orbs in the rocks behind you. These orbs, you need to take as a team to each of the flowers. How this works is that the 2 up top with the prisms will guide you to which flower is currently glowing. You have to sneak past the dogs, huddle around the flower, and once you do that, the player holding the prism will need to stand in the column of light and then shoot the flower. This will give everyone a x12 buff. This is the damage buff that you use on the dogs. The idea is to stack 4 of these buffs and then damage the dogs. However, it doesn't always work out this way. If someone gets caught, everything disappears and the dog will start to howl. When that happens, each dog will run to a specific flower every single time. During this time, you have a little over 30 seconds, I think it's like 35, something like that, to do as much damage as possible to each one of the dogs, and then make it back to the start point, which is the safe zone. If you fail to make it back into this room, it's an instant kill. So, in order for this to go smoothly, everyone has to be designated a flower. That flower will always have a dog associated with it. During the howling, everyone needs to go to their designated flower. Get their dog's health down as much as possible, and then run back into the safe zone before the howling is over with. The players up top with the prism weapons will have to be the higher light players, and they will have to take the furthest dog from the safe zone, far left and far right. 1, because they can get there faster since they're up top, and 2, they can see their dog coming, so it makes it a little bit easier. The other 4 will have to be designated to the 4 remaining flowers, as far left and far right will be taken by the prism holders. So once everyone knows which flower and dog they are assigned to, try to stack as many damage buffs as possible, but you need to get a minimum of 2 stacks, which is x24. If you're below 280, then you're probably going to need to get 3 stacks. Once you have your damage stacked up to a sufficient level, or one of your team members gets caught, run to your flower. The dog will be facing it every time they start howling. Damage the dog as much as you can. 2/3 is ideal, but try to get them at least below half health, because they get stronger as the rounds go on. Once you think you dealt enough damage, run back to the safe zone and stay in there until the round resets. Once the doors open, the prism holders jump back up top, grab the crystals, and then start looking for the first glowing flower. Always call out the closest flower first. Again, try to get 3, if possible 4 stacks of damage before going back to your dog, but like I said, you need a minimum of 2. If you're a strong team, 2 is all you're going to need. Once you have enough stacks, run to your dog and kill it. If you do kill it, each and every one of you will have to kill them, because if you just kill one of your dogs, your sneaking time gets cut by around a third, so you have to sneak faster and you will have less time to do damage on top of their health increasing exponentially. That's something that you really don't want to deal with. So you're trying to kill your dogs all at the same time in the same round. Once you kill all the dogs, it's over, that's it. Now the front left and front right flowers, along with the center left and center right, are the easiest to get to. There's only one dog in your way, which is pretty easy to outmaneuver. However, the far left and far right ones are the toughest. If you have to go to the far ones, cut through the middle caves on the left and the middle caves on the right. This gives you direct access and you can skip 2 dogs entirely. Sneaking around the left or right side of the map is impossible due to their rotations. Going up the middle and then over is the absolute best way to do that. So yeah, that's really about it, guys. You have 3 chances in the safe room. On your 4th attempt, you have to kill the dogs. So if someone does get caught, it's not over. You have a couple more chances. Just remember, you only need 2 successful sneaking rounds to kill these things. Or if you're good enough and you get 4 buffs, you can kill your dog outright in 1 round. So, quick recap. Everyone gets assigned a flower. Front left, front right, center left, center right, back left, back right. The 2 back ones, the guys with the crystals will take care of. Memorize where your flower is and how to get back to the safe zone. Try to get at least 2 stacks of damage your first round, times 24, preferably 3 or 4 stacks, and then go do damage to your dog. Get your dog to a sliver of health or at least halfway, and then return back to the safe zone. On the next round, stack the damage again, and when you think you have enough, finish your assigned dog. One thing to remember is that the guys with the crystals have to take out beast handlers every now and then. They'll be coming out of the top doors on the left and right hand side. If you miss them and they rush the 4 people sneaking around, the guys on the ground can drop your purple orb and melee him. Do not shoot or you will alert the dogs. Melee only. If that happens, simply pick your orb back up from the start zone and then continue on. Do this and you're good to go. Another thing to remember is that you cannot sneak around forever. There is a timer. When you start to see the beasts get restless, you know that you're running out of time. So just try to do this as quickly as possible. And like I said, if you only get 1 or 2 stacks, always go do damage to your dog. Even if you have 1 stack, try to get some damage in, because if you just get 1 stack every round, you can technically kill him by the 4th round. However, that's really not the way to do this. You want to do this in 2 rounds with at least 2 stacks each round. Well, good luck, Guardians. Once you get some practice, you'll see that this challenge is actually really, really easy. Let the players up top with the prisms guide you and keep the chatter to a minimum. It only takes 1 quick burst with the crystal to make the flower explode, and then all 6 of you get the damage buff, even the other crystal holder on the other side of the map. Anyways, I'm out of here, y'all. As always, thank you all so much for watching and for supporting the channel. If you're new to Sly Nation, thanks for stopping by, and we would love to have you here with us. Subscribe for more Destiny 2 videos. Spank the thumbs up only if you enjoyed yourself. Keep those eyes open for more D2 videos, as well as raid guides coming out here very soon. But until then, this is your dude Sly, and I'll catch you guys next time.